shit, waitress! I need a drink. I haven't had a drink yet tonight. Shit, I gotta catch up with these people. I'm sure you're way the fuck ahead of me. How you doing? Now, it's mandatory to drink on the job. And don't fall down, because I ain't gonna be able to get your ass up. You are bigger than me, girl. I like big girls. Tall girls. Cheers. I'm happy to be back. You see, I don't like to get drunk before the show. I like to get fucked up during the show. Suckers walk, money talks, but it can't touch me like that. Misses all days of old, mama keeps here. Shit. Hey, waitress, while I'm checking this out, can you bring me another cocktail? I'm telling you, I'm sweating the shit out. As soon as I drink it, and I cop a little buzz, and then the sweat comes through, and I'm sober again, damn it. Oh, shit. What's going on, girl? Shit, what the? Wait a minute, excuse me. It's mandatory. You drink on the job, see? It's part of the deal. It's part of the deal. What other fucking job in the world is it mandatory to drink on the job? Hey, I don't want to be the only one drunk up here. Thank you, girl. Vic, leave her alone. Vic, leave her alone. We get the fuck away from her, all right? Can't have any trouble around here, shit. Well, I just got to say, how long we've been on tour, but it's been awesome. This has been fucking great. I'm throwing a party every night. I hope everybody's into it, because we ain't bullshitting nobody up here, right?
let the magic do the work for you. Cause honey, something reached out and touched me. Thank you.
a hot motherfucker here tonight. Everybody all right though? Is it sounding good? I mean, shit sounds fucking good up here. I don't remember the last time I played around here. But then again, once you get in the tequila world, you kind of forget a lot of things. So we did our best, folks. We did our best to try to make a deal with the food and beverage people around here, see if we could have some Cabo Wabo for y'all, but they turned me down, you know? They turned me down, but that's okay. I brought a few cases for myself. I'll share it with you. Girls, come on. Let's bring the whole fucking bottle out here. Come on. Shit, don't fuck around with them drinks. Here. No. Let's bring the whole fucking bottle out here, girl. No, here. You can have this shit. You gotta have about 12 of those before you get high. No, not the girls, the bottle. The bottle, you guys forgot the bottle. Oh, shit. Drinking beer, please. No, no, no. Oh, there we go. Well, first of all, here's the way we do it in Cabo. You got any cups? I hope I don't go to jail for this, but I'm gonna pass this around. Drunk son of a bitch up here. And by the way, that is not iced tea in there, folks. Something together, you see. And all of a sudden, I hear somebody knocking on my door. We're talking late, all right? So I said, honey, excuse me for a minute. I'm gonna go look out the window and see who's knocking on the fucking door, you know? Next door neighbor, see. So I looked down, I said, Eddie, what you want, brother? It's late. He said, yeah, but you know, I've been working on this song, and he said, Sammy, I need some lyrics. I need a bridge. And I look at Eddie, I said, Eddie, my old lady's gonna kill me, man. That's all right, man. Come on. Come on down. Come on down. So I said, Eddie's got a guitar around his neck. He's got a cigarette in one hand. He's got a bottle of booze in the other. I said, when Eddie's got those three things going on, he is not bullshitting. I said, brother, I'll be right down. So I reach over my drawer next to my bed. And I got my little stash box. Myself, not one, but two big fat ones. what you want, man. I said, look, check this out. So we got to jamming, we got to drinking, we got to smoking. And before I knew it, here come the sun. Up all night and your mouth is dry and you're high and the sun hits you in the eye. The sun can be a motherfucker. Like tomorrow morning, the sun's gonna be a motherfucker. So I said, Eddie, I got to go. So I went back upstairs. It's late now. Now it's really late, right? I said, baby, I'm back. You know, I tried to make a lot of noise and shit, you know. Trying to wake her back up. You know, I knocked over shit and stuff, you know, like. And she says, huh, hey, what's wrong, man? She said, why are you so late? I said, baby, I'm not late. I said, come on, you know, baby, you know, come on. She said, oh, not tonight. You know, the kids are going to be up pretty soon. And, you know, we just do it tomorrow. I said, honey, it is tomorrow. Anyway, she just kind of rolled over and gave me the cold shoulder. So I took some advice. I took some advice from my old buddy. And I just reached down between my legs and I eased the seatbelt. remember that in the old days, I never, you know, this, you know me, come on, I played every place in the fucking world, man, but I never played this place here before. This is cool. This is really cool. I'm really glad we got something like this. But in the old days, we used to play over at that round motherfucker. What is that, the Scope or something? That silly place, I can tell you straight up, one night on the VOA tour, I was on stage, I was singing, I was playing, I looked and I saw a bottle of whiskey coming right at me, right? And I just, I was like some super shit, man. I went, bam, I caught it, opened it up, drank, threw it down, kept playing. Motherfuckers didn't mess with me the rest of the night. That's the truth, though. No, they were still fucking with me, but it was all right, you know, shit. Another night, man, the brothers, I gotta tell you, on the 5150 tour when we played over there, and now, you know, they used to, back then, that's when things were really crazy, and after the show, Alex asked Eddie for a cigarette, you know, and Eddie goes, well, man, why don't you buy your own fucking cigarettes, you know, and he goes, Alex goes, come on, man, just give me a cigarette, you know, and they're all sweating like this, you know, and he lights it up, and Alex goes, what do you got, stick up your ass? And Ed goes, hey, fuck you, man. And them motherfuckers start fighting, all right? I'm talking about, like, I was new in the band, right? I've been in the band about, you know, 3 months or something. I'm going, oh, shit. There they go, man. And these guys, these are brothers fighting now. This ain't like enemies. These guys got deep shit that you don't even have with your enemies. They got some other shit going on. We couldn't pull them apart. Mikey and I, we had them by the head. We couldn't, man, they were like a red ant and a black ant. You ever see when two ants get together? They just lock up, man. And it was awesome. But anyway, we've had a lot of fun in this town, and about 1990-something, so I'm gonna get in trouble now, but it's 1990-something, I met my wife around here, all right, you know? And my wife, fell in love and all that shit, you know? I kind of like this place, so anyway, here's a song I want to dedicate to my two beautiful daughters that are here with my beautiful wife, and I'm gonna dedicate this song about being born, okay? Just be cool, it's all right, man. Sunday morning, I'm alone. thank you so much, man. I gotta tell you, since how I fell in love in this town, I guess we gotta play a love song, don't we? Don't we? Don't we? But don't worry, it's not mushy. It's not mushy. It's a badass love song, man. Oh, you even one too. About 1988, coming through here. It's right here. Thank you. See some of you people in Cabo, man. Be cool. I love it. We'll be back. This is what we do. Thank you so much for a great concert. Fucking Redheads rule, all right?